After becoming the youngest player ever to win a European Tour event, Matteo Manassero was tipped by most to be Europe's next number one. But after slipping out of the world top 1000, what happened to Matteo Manassero? Born the 19th of April 1993, Matteo was raised in the small town of Nagar, Italy. Manny was a natural at the game from a very young age, and once his parents saw how much he was enjoying it, they booked him in for a lesson at the Garda Golf Country Club with teacher professional Franco Mastroni. Manny dominated every level of the junior game. He was introduced to Alberto Bernardi at a very young age. He would mentor young Matteo and guide him down the path of greatness. That greatness came very quick. Manny entered the British Amateur Championship in 2009 at the ripe age of 16. Even more extraordinary, he beat England's Sam Hutsby in the final. This victory made him the youngest winner of the event and qualified him for the Open Championship. He accompanied greatness in the first round of the Open. Seeing the standard and etiquette set by Tom Watson and Sergio Garcia, Manassero matched their hand and continued his beautiful run of form. He went on to win the silver medal by being the leading amateur and finished a very impressive tied 13th. People were starting to take note. This wasn't just any old kid. This kid was going places. After proving to the world he had game, everyone was asking the dying question of when will you turn pro? But Manny was in no rush, and with a great team guiding him, he knew he had more experience to gain. After all his current success, Matteo topped the amateur world rankings and remained there for 18 weeks, only being dethroned when he turned pro. But before being dethroned, Manassero had more records to break as an amateur. He was invited to the Masters at Augusta and was ready to show a new set of fans just who Matteo Manassero was. After playing sublimely all week, Manny had once again proved that. He won Best Amateur and became the youngest player ever to make the cut at the Masters. At just 17 years old, still a boy but playing like a man, Matteo had nothing left to prove, and the time to turn pro was now. He began tearing it up on the European Tour and was building quite the fan base. He was landing himself in the top 10 spots week in, week out, and was very close to winning on several occasions. But it didn't take long to break through on his rookie season. Matteo won his first professional competition by 4 shots at the Castello Masters. With this win, he became the youngest player ever to win a European Tour event, and had just secured his card for the next 2 years. To top the year off, he was awarded the Sir Henry Cotton Award, joining names such as Nick Faldo and Tony Jacklin. He kicked off the new season where he left off, with another win, this time beating Frenchman Gregory Bordy by 1 shot, making him the first and second youngest player ever to win on the European Tour. His golf remained solid throughout the year, and he even dabbled a bit on the PGA Tour. But without taking his foot off the gas, Matteo had no intention of slowing down. He entered the Barclays Singapore Open in fine form, coming off multiple top 10s. He was taken down to the wire in his hardest win yet, beating South African Louis Oosthuizen in a playoff for his third European Tour win. This meant he was the first teenager to win 3 times on the European Tour. Nobody had made this big of an impact since Seve first came on the scene, and that's what people were comparing him to. But Manny hadn't even hit his peak yet. 2013 would be his best season to date. Shortly after turning 20 years old, Matteo won arguably the biggest event on the European Tour, the BMW Championship at Wentworth. After achieving so much so young, Matteo was on his way to legendary status. Every guy wanted to be him, and every girl wanted to be with him. There was no way this love story could end with a sad ending. With the 2014 Ryder Cup coming up, there was no doubt in anybody's mind that Matteo Manassero would be in that team. But fast forward a year, and sadly Manny didn't produce the results needed to make the team. Something wasn't right that year. He only managed a couple top 10s and slipped to 60th in the order of merit. But that's okay. Even greats can have blips in their careers. But this wasn't a blip. Matteo's high-speed career had just gotten into a horror crash. In 2015, his highest finish was tied 18th, and he only made 6 out of 22 cuts. 2016 was no better, as he bettered that record with 15 straight missed cuts. The following years, he found himself fighting for his tour card on 2 separate occasions and failing both times. After using up all his exemptions and sponsor invites in 2019, Manny was left with no status for 2020. For Matteo, the pandemic was a blessing. He had no choice but to take time off, something that was definitely needed before he completely lost his mind. On his return, he began playing on the Alps Tour, 2 tiers below the European Tour. Although it wasn't the usual high status he was used to, Matteo still took it very seriously and managed yet another career win, his first in 7 years. Although this looked like the start of a comeback, it begged the question of what actually happened to Matteo to landslide so hard. Matteo's goal was always to play full-time on the PGA Tour. Every time he visited and played in big events, he always felt he was 20 to 30 yards behind the other golfers. And if he wanted to compete on the big stage, he needed that extra yardage. At 6 feet tall, 185 pounds, Manny was no whippersnapper, but he was a little short off the tee. He was averaging 275 yards off the tee, which is quite low on the average, but he made up for it in accuracy. But seeking that goal, Matteo began working on body changes and swing changes, looking to gain a few extra pounds for a few extra yards. But upon that quest, Matteo lost all control of his swing, and gaining that extra weight and muscle completely threw his feel off, and his short game was now suffering too. With not enough hours in the day to practice to the detail he wanted, his once fluent flow was now a blocky, stubby mess. Once you make that decision to change, there is really no going back. You can't spend hours, days, months, years grooving a new swing to suddenly change your mind and say, "Nope, didn't work, think I'll have my old swing back now, please." The damage is done, there's no going back from that. Although it feels Matteo has been around forever, he's still only 28 years old, which in golfing terms is nowhere near his peak. With the game now longer than ever, he would be stupid to continue that quest of getting longer. He needs to find his niche again with all the smaller and accurate hitters, and put the pressure on them by always being in play and being dangerous around the greens. I can't see a win on the PGA Tour for Matteo, but I think he'll find his way back on the European Tour. And hopefully, if he can find his old rhythm, strive for that European comeback win. The thing is, we'll probably be hearing this story again very soon in the future. With the top players ramping up the distances, and the PGA lengthening the courses, this game is for the power hitters now, and if you can't keep up, you'll be left behind.